and welcome to the first edition of Event Center on your brand new local television channel, The Box. We're here to give you a rundown of all the events Timmins has to offer twice a week. Tonight, we'll spook you, entertain you, play music for you, inform you, and maybe even help you find a map. Hi, I'm Bonnie Autio, the host of this thing we call Event Center. A little later in the program, I'll be joined by Jason Tessier to look at a busy weekend in local sports. We'll take a look at how Timmins warmed up for Halloween this past weekend. We'll give you a taste of our Sons of Maxwell special on The Box this week. We'll take a sneak peek at this Friday's Bachelor Auction with one of the hosts, Dave McLaughlin, and we'll let you know what's up around town. But first, let's get into the Halloween mood a little. Take-Two Theater held their first Halloween dinner theater at the Dante Club on Saturday. Over 150 people attended, some in costume, others too spooked to take a chance. Let's take a look at some of the highlights.
Welcome to this evening of hilarious thrills and blood-curdling chills. Take-Two Theater is sponsoring this wonderful dinner theater that hopefully will keep you hanging on to your seat, hanging on to your hair, and hopefully scaring the devil out of you. Well, we have a variety of members from all sorts of areas in the community. We have teachers, we have students, we have moms, we have dads, we have a whole gambit of individuals with all sorts of exciting personalities that are just waiting to get opportunities to come out of those little cubby holes and do something fun and exciting and different from their regular routines. We've got a little bit of singing, we've got some dancing, we've got a few very cute little skits, we've got a little bit of a chiller that will certainly make the hair rise on the back of your neck, and then of course included in the evening as well we have the dinner and then a dance afterwards.
That Al did that. He's a good friend of mine, and seeing as I was sitting right under his feet, I think he spotted me, and away we went.
Interesting. It was different. I've never seen anything like this before. So.
Yeah, it was different. I liked the way they had everything set up around the room. Everybody was moving here, there, and everywhere.
Look for Take-Two Theater's next performance. They'll be bringing back their Love Boat theme just in time for Valentine's Day. You're watching the premiere episode of Event Center on The Box, your local event source. I'm Bonnie Autio. While we're in the Halloween spirit, let's take a look at another haunting. Various establishments around town celebrated Halloween a little earlier than usual this past weekend. Casey's Restaurant held their annual party Saturday. The local band Authority played to an unusual-looking crowd. Even the band participated by donning popular infants' wear. And while we're on the move, let's check out a dart tournament and other things around town. Wednesday morning from 10 to noon, the Anxiety and Panic Disorder Self-Help Group meets at 239 Wilson Avenue. Call the Canadian Mental Health Association at 267-8100 for more information. Wednesday night at 7:30, the Porcupine Rod and Gun Club will be having their annual nomination meeting. All members and other interested people are invited to join them in the Sportsplex conference room. You can call Lena Gallant at 268-6312 for more information. Moving on to Thursday, the Porcupine United Way will be holding the third of their report luncheons at noon at the House of Yee in the 101 Mall. The cost is $10, with all proceeds to the United Way. Call the March of Dimes to confirm at 267-2183. And Timmins and District Childmind is hosting their 5th Annual Children's Halloween Party Thursday from 4:30 till 8 p.m. at the Moose Hall, Pine Street North in Timmins. All children are invited. Admission is only $1. Besides the normal Halloween activities, the party will also instruct children about safety. Call the Child Find office at 268-7799 for more information.
Timmins Legion 88 and Mixed Art League is having a Mixed Art Tournament Saturday, November 2nd. Only the first 20 teams will be accepted. For more information or to register, call 268-4791.
Stay tuned as later in the program we take a look at our upcoming Sons of Maxwell concert.
They're closing the mine. I've been here since I was in my prime. Now where will I go and who will I see? Who wants a miner as time?
You're watching Event Center on the Box, your local event source on Cable Channel 10 in Timmins. I'm Bonnie Autio. As you know, the Alzheimer's Society will be hosting their second annual bachelor auction. With me in the studio to talk about this is Dave McLaughlin. Hi, Dave.
Hi, Bonnie. How are you?
I'm good. I understand this is the second year you're hosting this bachelor auction, and you have an extra special co-host.
Yes, my wife, Karina Rona, will be doing the festivities along with me. We had so much fun last year, we thought we'd do it again. Why not?
I don't expect she'll be making any bids on the bachelors.
No, I think she'd be, no, she better not. I don't think so.
So tell me about this auction. What happens at it?
The way it works is we have 26, 27 single guys in the area. They strut their stuff, so to speak. Ladies in the audience bid on them. The highest bidder gets dinner for two at a restaurant around town. And from there, whatever happens, happens. And it all benefits the Alzheimer's Society.
And does it ever get fierce, the bidding? Does it get competitive?
Last year, there was it got a little much. We had prices ranged, everything sounded like a let's make a deal. Everything from $65 to $500.
$500?
Oh, yeah. Some ladies come there on a mission, and they get their man.
Well, I understand that a romance brewed out from this auction.
Mm-hmm. One of the farriers, I think it's Andrew, okay, one of the farrier brothers, ended up meeting a girl there, and they're getting married in a couple of months.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
So how does anybody find out, how do they get tickets to this event?
Tickets are $20. There are only a few left. I know it sounds like a cliche, but there really only is. That includes your Dante Club dinner, which is always great. Tickets at the Alzheimer's Society office on 3rd Avenue, NorCan Travel, Oasis Experience. Those are a couple other spots, but those are the few that come to mind.
Okay. Sounds like a good place for the single women to be.
Yeah, it's going to be a good time.
Okay. Thanks, Dave.
No problem.
This is Event Center, your twice-weekly review and preview of events in Timmins on the Box. One of Hollywood's hits last year was the film Dangerous Minds, so it should come as no surprise that this year there's a parody of it. To talk about that and other things happening at the movies, here's Gary Schelling. Hi, Gary.
Hi, Bonnie.
So what's the name of this new film?
The new film is called High School High. It opened last Friday at Cinema 6. It stars John Lovitz of Saturday Night Live fame. You may remember him. He was the liar, and he's been doing a lot of support roles in movies lately, but this is his first chance to star. The film's produced by the same guys who did the Naked Gun movie, so you can expect much
of
the same.
Don't you think the kids would enjoy a nice song with a melody?
What you got, Holmes?
It is a rare, one-of-a-kind original pressing.
Oh, yeah? All right, man, I'm going to put it on there for you, all right?
Thanks.
Like a rhinestone cowboy.
High School High opened this past weekend at Cinema 6. Also opening this past weekend, the latest movie adapted from a Stephen King novel, just in time for Halloween, Thinner. And to round out the new movies, Whoopi Goldberg takes a shot at corporate America in The Associate. Continuing, Dustin Hoffman, Robert De Niro, and Brad Pitt are just a part of the all-star cast in Sleepers, the supposedly true story about revenge in New York's Hell's Kitchen. The First Wives Club has Diane Keaton, Bette Midler, and Goldie Hawn starring in another story of revenge, this one a little more trashy. And Michael Douglas teams up with Val Kilmer to tell a story of turn-of-the-century Africa in The Ghost and the Darkness. Also of note, Monday night at 7 for one show only at Cinema 6, the Timmins Film Society presents Trainspotting, the infamous movie about heroin addicts in Scotland. Tickets are available in advance for $7 at Sam the Record Man, Lauren's One Stop Esso, The Second Cup, and the Info Booth at Timmins Square, The Daily Press, and Cinema 6, or you can get your tickets at the door. And that's it, Bonnie.
Well, I guess a lot of people have been waiting to see that Trainspotting film.
Yeah, we've had a lot of requests with the Film Society to bring that in. I think we're going to have a lot of high school students at that one.
Okay, good. Thanks, Gary. Stay with us on Event Center. When we come back, we'll have Jason Tessier to wrap up this weekend's local sports.
I find they've got to hit a little bit more, pass, skate, but all in all, I'm enjoying the game.
As you probably know, this is a brand new show on a brand new channel, so we'd like your feedback. Tell us what you think about Event Center and The Box. You can do that by calling our response line anytime, day or night. The number? 267-5500. If you'd like to talk to us here in the office, just call the same number during office hours. 267-5500. Or if you prefer, you can fax us with announcements about upcoming events at 264-0121. This is Event Center on The Box, your local event source in Timmins. I'm Bonnie Autio. On Saturday, there was a craft sale in the cafeteria of Roland Michener Secondary School, with proceeds going to RMSS Athletics. The selection of items was utterly infinite.
There's about 31 different exhibitors. We have anywhere from knitting, woodwork, ceramic works that I have myself. There's things done with rocks, different dried flower arrangements, jewelry.
Also on Saturday, the Timmins Square was the site of this year's charity fair. Representatives from local charities were there to talk with people about their organizations, and there was literature and draws for people to enter. You're watching Event Center on The Box, your local event source on Cable Channel 10 in Timmins. I'm Bonnie Autio. And joining me right now to wrap up local weekend sports is Jason Tessier and Sports Wrap. Hi, Jason.
How you doing?
I guess you were at your usual haunt this weekend?
Yes, I was at all of the local arenas, and we had minor hockey, we had Bears hockey, and Maiders hockey as well.
Wow, so what are we going to start with?
Well, we're going to start with Maiders hockey first.
Okay.
The Maiders were host to the North Bay Trappers on Sunday afternoon. After gaining a 3-0 lead, the Maiders managed to hold off the Trappers and come away with a win by a score of 4-3. The Maiders play tonight against Kapuskasing. Game time is 7:40 p.m. at the McIntyre Arena. The President's Cup tournament finished up last night. Here are the results.
The Kitten Prospectors beat Kronk's Construction 5-0. The Ron knocked off the Rotary Rebels by a score of 4-0. Schumacher Day edged Contact Sports 1-0. Timmins Sharks came out on top of Barry's Car Sales 3-2. And the Timmins Ice Dogs pounded Bandor 15-0. In two games on Sunday, Tilden beat Monarch Automation Bulldogs 6-1. A&D Trophies lost to Richelieu by a score of 6-1. The Millette Panthers burned Martin Fuels 4-1. And Legion 88 defeated Moneta by a score of 3-0.
On Monday night, Porcupine Lobes lost to Sauvé Lumber 6-0. And Bank of Montreal lost to Carpetman 6-0.
Friday night, the Bears hosted the Elliott Lake Vikings. Despite being outplayed, the Vikings kept it close.
Final score was 6-5.
On Sunday afternoon, the Perry Sound Shamrocks were at the Sportsplex. After the Shamrocks made it 3-1 in the second, one fan had this to say.
Well, I've been watching the Bears first period. I noticed that the defensemen are letting them go into them. They don't take them at the blue line.
And it cost them a goal, I understand, too.
Yeah, it just cost them a goal there just a while ago.
At the end of the second, the score was 3-2 for the Shamrocks. Most people were enjoying the game despite the score.
It's going very well, I find. They've got to hit a little bit more, a pass, skate, but all in all, I'm enjoying the game.
Well, Tucker's made several good saves. He's He stopped about three breakaways, but unfortunately they're behind right now. He's playing really well.
Parry Sound have got a pretty good team, I find. But they're well matched.
In the third, the Shamrocks scored two quick goals to pull ahead 5-2. The Bears scored on a power play to make it 5-3.
Joel, tell me what happened for that last Bears goal.
Okay, well, the defense grabbed the puck, took a shot, and Martin Birch got the rebound, shot into the net, and they got the goal. And then, well, all I have to say is the goalie didn't have a chance.
With the score 6-3, Birch scored a second of the game. After that, things got a little chippy.
Some guy just came up behind him, and some guy was skating, and he just went twack and just hit him right in the knee. Now, I don't know.
No more goals were scored, but fans were still excited by the four fights that took place in the third, with the best one being Spencer Verdeel's bout. The Bears' next game is this Friday against the Sturgeon Falls Lynx. Game time is 8 p.m. at the Sports Club.
So that's our word for today, Bonnie. Ka-twack.
Pretty rough game, eh?
Yeah, it was pretty rough. There were about four fights in the third period alone, but the Bears seemed to come out on top for most of them, so it was okay.
Okay, so what are you working on for us for Friday?
Friday, we'll be taking a look at the Northern Classic Curling Bonspiel that'll be happening at the McIntyre Curling Club. And, of course, there'll be action in the local arenas as well this weekend.
As per usual. Yes. Thanks, Jason.
No problem.
You're watching Event Center on the Box. A few weeks ago, the Daily Press, along with Northern Cable, held its second Entertainer of the Year awards at École Secondaire Terrio. A big part of that evening was entertainment by last year's winners, the Sons of Maxwell. The Box is proud to bring you the concert this Wednesday and Thursday. And here's a small taste of Don and Dave's talent and maybe an indication of why they take the name the Sons of Maxwell.
Well, you had more than a few requests for this next song, which our father wrote. It's called Closing the Mine.
They're closing the mine. They're closing the mine. I've been here since I was in my prime. Now where will I go? And who will I see? Once a miner as tired as me. Now the gold is mostly gone, so the shareholders say. We're close at all mine, so we don't have to pay. The miners can go, for they've had their day. Christmas is coming and this will be. And I've worked many years with loose over my head. We carry a lot of our friends from here dead. And they told us today that we'll have to go. Our paydays are over and I'm feeling low. So they're closing the mine. They're closing the mine. I've been here since I was in my prime. Now where will I go? And who will I see? Who wants a miner as tired as me? And I've filled up my lungs with dust from that mine. I've been here since I was in my prime. Now they're closing the mine. They're closing the mine. Where will I go now? They're closing the mine.
Just a reminder, that's Wednesday and Thursday night right here on The Box. That brings us to the end of our first episode of Event Center. Thanks to everyone who made this happen and all the extra hours everybody put into getting this show on the air. We'll be back Friday with a full-length show that'll review the week and preview everything going on in town this weekend. If it happens in Timmins, you'll see it on Event Center. For everybody here, I'm Bonnie Autio. We'll see you Friday.